On the 8th of September, top lightweight contenders go head-to-head in Shanghai, and the stakes could not be any higher. Banario is eyeing a second shot at a world title, while Khan is looking to bring pride and glory to his country. Deep in the highlands of northern Luzon, Philippines, lies the massive Cordilleran mountain range. While some love and others fear this mystical land, for Honorio Banario, it is simply home. Unbeknownst to many, the proud Igorot warrior was once plagued by bullies due to his painfully shy personality.
Growing up, I experienced bullying in school. That's why sometimes I need to fight with this classmate of mine. I don't have confidence and they keep bullying me. The best thing I do is stay away from them.
In college, Banario studied criminology. He wanted to defend powerless people like him from the bullies of society. He joined the school's Muay Thai team and later received an athletic scholarship. Little did he know, martial arts would change the course of his life forever.
After I trained a little bit of Muay Thai, I trained boxing, and then they offer in our school Wushu. So they selected me to be a part of the junior national team. I take the opportunity because I'm very grateful in martial arts. It saved me from vices.
Like Banario, Singapore's Amir Khan also faced bullying in his youth. He was severely teased in school because he was different.
When I was growing up, I was dealing with Tourette's. Being amongst people could be really tough because I was embarrassed to be myself. Okay, Tourette's basically is a neurological disorder. You have uncontrollable tics around your body. Sometimes you feel itchy, you want to scratch it off. That's what I feel on a daily basis.
When he come back from school, sometimes he will cry to me. Everybody behind me making fun of me, and I can't focus on anything.
I was socially awkward, can't really go out on dates or let's say go out with my friends. No one wants to hang out with me because it's not as cool as them because I got this weird habit.
Khan's involuntary tics were at its worst when he was 13 years old. He was shunned because of his condition. But the teenager found solace at a Muay Thai gym where he was not judged.
I remember the first day I joined the gym, I decided I just want to train as much as possible and be good at the sport. And then whenever I feel down or feel all the negative emotions, like I said, I take it out of the gym. With only 6 months training, I won. And I just felt, this is just the best feeling ever. Evolve means to grow, to become better, like to improve 1% every day. Everyone was so welcoming of me. Even though I'm different, no one treat me any differently. They treat me the same.
Banario draws his strength and endurance from his ancestors. These are the Igorot warriors, feared amongst their enemies for their perseverance, will, and ferocity in battles. Bringing the warrior spirit every time he steps into the cage, Banario made history in 2013 when he captured the inaugural One Featherweight World Championship. He became the first ever Filipino and Team Lakai martial artist to win the coveted world title.
It means a lot. If you're a world champion, you have the bigger responsibility. You have to work harder than before to stay on the top. So I think that's pushed me to surpass my limit and improve my skills.
While Banario draws his strength from his ancestors, Amir Khan is a hungry young lion who is determined to prove he's ready for a shot at the world title. The Singaporean is known for his knockout power, and holds the highest number of knockouts in ONE Championship history. His quest for greatness has taken the Evolve athlete across different continents to learn from the best martial artists.
I went to train like the Thais. I developed that mental toughness in Thailand. Knowing that I completed that training, knowing that most people can survive it, just gave me that upper edge. And then when I was 16 or 17, I heard MMA is getting bigger globally, and I had a friend in the state. He invited me over. So I went there for like 3 months holiday just to learn MMA. And then I just fell in love with that sport because you can develop your own unique style suited to your individual personality. I did not focus on getting a knockout power because you can't force on it. It has to come naturally. I just focus on the whole aspect of the game.
Oh, the big kibosh! Another first round finish for the stunning Amir.
Oh, a huge, huge right hand.
Mental strength was what got Banario through a testing period when his career took a downward spiral after losing his featherweight belt.
It might be, he might have this deep state.
He's tapped, it's over.
There were harsh lessons learned, but the Filipino warrior returned stronger.
It's like I just hold it for 3 months and then it went away. What I learned is even if you are a champion, there is no different from the other fighters. Right now you're holding the belt, tomorrow it's gone. It teaches me to be humble and to be equal to other fighters.
With the support and guidance of Team Lakai, Banario decided to move up to the lightweight division. He has been on a blistering run since, scoring 5 straight victories.
He's tapped out, it's over! Banario improves his record.
And Banario credits his resurgence to the training methods at Team Lakai.
I just focus on the training, focus on my game plan in order to go back and redeem myself and become a champion again one day. Team Lakai for those is champion because they are all in love in martial art. They have this will, never give up until they reach their dreams.
I'm glad to open people's eyes around the world that Singapore can produce local born and bred fighters. Yeah, I feel this is my time, man. I just got to prove to the world I deserve the title shot. I have to really finish him in the first or second round.
I am better than American in every aspect of the game because I train harder, I'm faster, I'm stronger. I seen him gas out as the fight goes on, getting slower. If he faces a tough opponent, he runs away.
I believe he's at his peak right now because he used to be more one-dimensional. He will never take the guy down. Right now, he's more well-rounded fighter. So, I mean, I'm honored to face him at his best, but I don't think he's as hungry as me. And I feel this is my time. I just got to put all the energy in that ring. We are both hungry lions. We are both looking to make a statement. Let's see who's the better man tonight.
The stage is set on the 8th of September for an intense night of action in Shanghai, China, the Philippines versus Singapore. Team Lakai versus Evolve MMA. Will the spirit of the Igorot warrior reign supreme? Or can the hungry young lion prove that his time is now?